Hi everyone, my name is Jen and this is Bee's House of Plants, where we talk about all things house sand and home design. Welcome back. So I'm so excited to bring you another episode of my series, the House Sand Alphabet, where I introduce you to some of my house sands. We talk about my experience growing them and what conditions they are currently receiving in my home. Just a reminder once again that I'm not an expert. This is not a definitive care guide. We're just talking about my experience here. If you notice that I am wearing the same clothes as yesterday's episode, that's because I'm going to record a bunch of episodes for this series today. So if you haven't checked out yesterday's or any of the previous episodes, I'll make sure to link the playlist down in the description box for you. Also, reminder, I am going to be doing that sticker fundraiser for the Senate runoff races in Georgia. So I'll make sure to leave a link in the description for that as well. Well, okay, let's get into today's video. So today's video is F is for the fiddle leaf fig. Okay, so this is my fiddle leaf fig. It's on the ground right now. So let me try to lift it up a little bit. That's my fiddle. I'm sure you guys know what a fiddle leaf fig looks like. Here, this is partially in frame right here. Maybe I can put it on the ground right here so that it's kind of sort of in frame. Well, it's barely in frame, but it's fine. Okay, so let's talk about the fiddle leaf fig, the plant that previously took the internet by storm. If you've been watching my channel for a while now, you'll know that I had a little bit of a contentious start with this fiddle leaf fig in the beginning, but I really feel like I've gotten my rhythm with it and it looks great now. Okay, so the story with this fiddle leaf fig is that when I was just starting out, you know, collecting plants, owning house plants, obviously I wanted a fiddle because everyone had a fiddle leaf fig and I wanted to be cool too. So I was at Home Depot one day. They had a bunch of fiddle leaf figs on sale and I decided not to grab one because I was like, oh, they're so hard though. Everyone says they're so finicky. Like, ah, I don't know yet. And then I left and then I regretted not buying one. And so I decided finally for the next day to go back, and there was one fiddle leaf fig left. It was this one and was still on sale. So that's the story of how I acquired this plant. So the reason I say that we had a very contentious start is that when I got it home, pretty much like immediately the next day, all the leaves were like turned down. It was so, so droopy, so, so incredibly unhappy. And about 2-3 weeks in, I noticed that the soil for the plant was still soaking wet, which I knew that although it's a rather big plant, that's not normal for the soil of the plant to be still wet 2-3 weeks later. And everyone says not to repot a fiddle because they're so, so, so finicky, but I decided to do it anyways because it was so unhappy and the soil was like soaking wet. So when I unpotted this fiddle leaf fig, I found out that although the pot, like if you looked at the pot that it was in, there was drainage holes at the bottom, but someone had put in another layer of like a plastic lining tray on the inside of the regular nursery pot so that all of the holes, all of the drainage holes were completely covered. I have no idea why someone would do that because that would have definitely killed the plant if I just left it like that. So, since this is one of the very first plants that I bought, I didn't really know about like soil or anything like that. So that first time after I repotted it into a 50% like moisture controlled Miracle-Gro, maybe like a 30% cactus Miracle-Gro soil, and then like 20% of Miracle-Gro perlite, which, if you watched me now, you'll know that I freaking hate Miracle-Gro. I just despise that stuff. I would never buy Miracle-Gro for my plants now. Also, that bag of Miracle-Gro is what gave me fungus gnats. So, no. So yeah, that was the original soil mix that I put it in, and it was fine. It was okay. Eventually, over like a week or so, the leaves stopped being like so droopy. Like they stopped like pointing to the ground, but they weren't necessarily happy. And the key with fiddle leaf figs is that you should never move them. You pick a spot, assess the environment, make sure that it's getting enough light, it's not near like an air vent or whatever, you place it there, and then you just literally like never move it again. So after 3 or 4 months, it was fine and did okay. It didn't grow or anything, but it wasn't like actively dying, and it stopped looking like absolutely miserable. So eventually I repotted it again, because this is when I started learning about soil mixes, and that Miracle-Gro bag had a ton of fungus gnats, and also Miracle-Gro soil stays wet for a really, really long time. So I ended up repotting it again early this year, early 2020, which feels like it's beginning of 2020 still, but no, we're in November. So I repotted it at the beginning of 2020 in my arrowed mix. It was like 50% orchid bark. So the mixture is orchid bark, coco coir, pumice, horticultural charcoal. I have so many videos about my soil mix, but that was like the mix. And I put quite a bit of orchid bark into the soil mixture, despite the fact that this is a ficus, and ficuses actually have like kind of fine root systems. Surprisingly, despite how big their leaves are, they have actually quite small root systems. So I repotted it, and then I also moved the plant. Oof, I know. It was previously in a south-facing window, but that was prime real estate, and this plant didn't really like me, so why would I give this plant prime window real estate? So I chucked it to a different room with an east-facing window, and lo and behold, it started growing. It put out 3 leaves back-to-back, pretty much like 2-3 weeks after I repotted it that second time, and moved it to an east-facing window, and so now we live happily ever after. Okay, so let's talk a little bit more in depth about my current care for this plant. So at the moment, this plant is being grown under a grow light. I just moved it. I know I told you not to move it, but I just moved it recently. So now it's currently being grown under one of my Sansi grow bulb lights. I'll link the exact one I have in the description below. It's just on the ground, so the distance between the light and the bulb is quite far. It's at least like 3 or 4 feet. So it's quite far, but I really do think it's getting enough light, and the light is directly on top of the plant, which also means that you don't have to rotate your plant, which is nice. So previously it was in an east facing window, and I really do think it was the happiest there. Most people will tell you that the fiddle needs more light than that you should really put it in a south facing window. But mine was perfectly happy in an east facing window. It is an east facing window that was not shaded, so like there was nothing blocking the window, like no trees or anything. But yeah. Okay, so for watering this plant in the winter time, which is the season we're heading into right now, I really do not water this plant at all. I water it about once a month in the winter time. Do keep in mind that currently my plant is in a large pot. It's in about a 12-inch size pot, and obviously the bigger the pot, the longer it takes for the soil within it to dry out. So if you're in a significantly smaller pot, like maybe say a 6-inch size pot, you probably do want to water it a little bit more frequently than that. But in the wintertime, I really, really don't water this plant a whole lot at all. Also because the plant doesn't grow that much in the winter time. This is one of the very few plants that I notice a very distinct pattern between a growing season and like a dormant season. In the summertime, I do water it more frequently. I water about every other week in the summertime. For fertilizer, I fertilize this plant in the active growing season only. So I stopped fertilizing this plant in the winter time. And the majority of the time when I have fertilized this plant in the past, it was with a fish fertilizer. A fish fertilizer is made from like fish poop, and it's pretty much all organic, so it's really, really good. I don't, like, the exact one I use, I got at a local nursery, and it's not available on Amazon, but I'll link a very similar one on Amazon for you. It has the same NPK ratio as the one I use, and I've seen other people use that brand, so I feel like okay recommending it. So yeah, I know that a lot of companies will sell, like, plant food or plant fertilizer that's specifically labeled for fiddle leaf figs. I really haven't, I don't see a need, because at the end of the day, it's all the same kind of, like, nutrients if you break it down. So I really don't see why you would need a specific fertilizer for the fiddle leaf fig, considering that it's a ficus, which is a very, you know, like, common species of plant. Like, it's not like an orchid or anything, which would need a slightly different amount of NPK, but I've never bought one of those, so I can't recommend them, and I can't, you know, like, give you a review on whether or not they are good. But yeah. So, another trick that you can do with your fiddle leaf fig is whenever you water it, you can also do this, hold it at the stem and give it a little bit of a shake. A, that gets, you know, a lot of the water droplets off the leaf, and B, it kind of stimulates wind for the plant, which helps the plant, grow bigger roots and better roots, because it feels like it needs to anchor itself more securely into the soil. Just a little wiggle, a little wiggle. Okay, so now that we've talked about sun, we've talked about watering, we've talked about fertilizing, let's talk about propagation and branching out. So, since last year, I think my fiddle has grown a total about 6 or 7 leaves, I think, in the past year. It's about this height now, or it was about, like, this height. And then I decided that I think this is a good enough height, and I wanted to take a propagation off the top, A, because propagating plants is fun, but B, also because I would like my fiddle leaf fig to start branching out. So when you cut the top of the, so when you cut off the very top part of the plant, that does something called, like, a petiole dominance, I believe, or it triggers something called a petiole dominance, where the plant will start sending down a signal down to the rest of the plant and starts activating other nodes below, you know, the part that you cut off, therefore will encourage the plant to start growing branches out of several nodes at once. So that's how you get your plant to branch. You can also do that with, like, a rubber tree. That's also a ficus. It's not too common with plants like philodendrons. A lot of times with philodendrons, when you cut the top off, it only will activate a single node, but sometimes it does happen. It did happen with one of my philodendron Burgundy Princess, where I cut off the top and it actually activated 2 nodes, so it branched out. That's really, really cool. So how you would do that is that you would just you would just cut off, you know, in between 2 leaves, make sure you get a sizable portion of the stem. And then, so you cannot propagate this plant with just the leaf or the petiole, which is the part that holds the leaf to the stem. You do need the actual stem itself. So I cut it off. So as you can see, this is the stem, right? That's the stem. This is the petiole, where the leaf attaches to the stem. So you can see my fiddle leaf propagation is going very, very well. I just stuck it in a little bit of water. It's just tap water, plain tap water. And then I forgot about it for a really long time. And then I checked it and voila, a ton of roots. It really didn't do a whole lot in the beginning, which is why I forgot about it. It didn't start rooting till about 3 weeks in, but once it starts to put out roots, it goes really, really quickly after that. I think I'm gonna wait a little bit longer, maybe a couple more weeks, and then I'm actually going to try to put this section of the fiddle leaf fig, or the Ficus lyrata, into LECA, into a passive hydroponic system, because I want to see how well it does in that. I actually think that it'll probably do quite well in a passive hydro system because these roots have never been in soil. They are water propagated roots. So yeah, I do think this is the easiest method of propagation. You can also alternatively just stick it into soil, but I'm nosy and I like to see the roots, so I like water propagating. I don't change out the water particularly very often. If you see, you know, like algae or anything, you should probably change out your water. It helps to change out the water fairly often because then you are re-oxygenating the roots. But yeah, I don't think it's the end of the world if you leave the water in there for too long. I think the key to a really happy fiddle leaf fig is just you need to leave it alone. It doesn't really like it when you touch the leaves. It doesn't really like it when you give it too much attention or move it or anything like that. So the best way to keep a fiddle leaf fig happy is to just let it be. All right, so I think that's all I have for you today. If you have any questions or if I missed anything, let me know in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like it, give me a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye!